Good morning, students. Today, for the classwork, we will continue with bar charts. Now, as I have already told you, that either bar charts can be vertical or horizontal, as in this case. So, that won't create a very big issue. Rather, what you have to focus that you must observe what are the coordinates, as I told you here. See that number of plants over the horizontal part and the number of flowers on the vertical part. I will just take care of that. Now, this bar chart particularly focuses on the four different flowers. I repeat, four different flowers in the garden. Now, the counting can be observed. See, the numbers over here are given and the bars touch over a particular line. So, first thing to do, being able to solve this sum, you need to write down the individual of each type. You will get that particular question, but remember that if such question is never given in the particular set of the bar chart, you must find it out. Now we move to the questions. Name the type of flower which is present the most and the least. So for these types of comparisons also, what are the different quantities in which the flowers are present in the garden, it should be found out. Quantities, by quantities I mean to say counting. Okay. In what counting the number of flowers, the flowers are present of each type should be found out first. Now, find the number of flowers of each type. See that this question has been just followed to the part B. So, it can be given in any manner, but major thing is that you must continue finding the number of flowers of each type for this type of particular bar chart, so that if any comparison based sum is given, then you can easily solve it. And wherever calculations are required, students, my suggestion is that you please show the calculation, okay? Because sometimes it may happen there are some large numbers that you need to deal with, and if you were not doing the calculation, sometimes error may take place. So in order to avoid that error, please show the calculations wherever required. It won't take much time. Now coming to question number C. Find how many more daisy flowers are there in the garden than rose. See that. Here you can get the comparison, how many more daisy flowers are present than the rose in the garden. Very easily you can do that after you have found out or after you have put down the flowers of each type. We move to the next page. Find the sum of number of flowers present in the garden. Now regarding this question, I have already informed you that whenever such types of questions are given, what you need to do, you need to add up the values only. Simple adding up the values of each type and then you are getting that answer. Now if you come to the chart again, you can see that how many daisy flowers, how many tulip flowers, how many rose flowers, how many lily flowers are present in the garden. So simple thing, you first observe their counting and then sum up all these four countings. Now we come to question number two. Now if you see closely, this is the bar chart representing the number of absentees in a week ranging from Monday to Saturday. We have considered 6 days for this thing, considering that Sunday is a holiday. For any purpose, it might be for the school, office. Okay. Now, you see that on Monday, we have got a certain number of absentees for Tuesday, similarly for Wednesday. As I have told you, informed you in previous graph while doing the class, that whenever you find that two numbers are given over here along the y-axis and in between any intermediate value is found. Suppose here 130 and 140. This is the intermediate value. So here I will get 135 absentees for particularly Wednesday. Now again you move to Thursday, Friday and Saturday. You have already come across these types of bar charts in earlier, either in classes or during the video lessons. Now again, first thing to do, as I told you, if the question regarding each day absentees is not given, still you find it out whether you have to do a comparison or you have to find some of the values. These things will be helpful. Now we move to the next part. The questions are given over here. One by one we'll move to the chart also. Find the number of absentees on each day of the week. As I was saying, so you have to find the number of absentees separately for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. So for all the 6 days, you have to find the number of absentees. Now, क्वेश्चन नंबर बी, नेम द डेज ऑन विच द नंबर ऑफ एब्सेंटीज वेर मोस्ट एंड विच द नंबर ऑफ एब्सेंटीज वेर लीस्ट. सो इफ यू कम अक्रॉस ओवर हियर, यू कैन फाइंड आउट ऑन विच डे द नंबर ऑफ एब्सेंटीज वेर मोस्ट एंड ऑन विच डे द नंबर ऑफ एब्सेंटीज वेर लीस्ट. सो दीज थिंग्स यू हैव टू डू, जस्ट कीप इन माइंड दैट दीज टू थिंग्स यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम द paragraph also you can find out, or from the values that you have taken up, there also you can find out. Find the sum of absentees on Monday, Wednesday and Friday. Now see that for particularly these types of sum, question number C, we'll come to the board here, over here, Monday, Wednesday and Friday. These 3 days, the number of absentees you already have with you. Now you need to sum up these values only, and then your work would be done. Okay, now moving to the last question. Find the sum of absentees on the 6 days of the week. As you know, this type of sum would also be given, where you have to find the sum of the absentees on the 6 days of the week. Individually, you have found out the number of absentees on each day of the week, so you need to add them up. So this will be the final answer to this particular bar chart. Thank you, students.